Five. Mm-hmm. Okay, get some of that smoke in there. Okay. And you want to just wait a minute, okay? Because what's going to happen is the bees are going to, they're going to smell that smoke, and they're going to start eating honey. Okay, and then they're, you know, in theory.
Check the mic and make sure it sound right, boys.
Here at YouTube. Oh well, I'm here getting ready for the winter. I got bees flying around, feeding wild bees. That's what I'm doing today. Feeding our bees is today's lesson. Now, not everyone feeds their bees. Some people let nature take care of their bees. And that's okay if you feel that way, and I'm not against it. But when things get really tough and the mites' viral load gets high, what are you going to do? Want your bees to make it? You don't want them to be crippled while they're making it. It's like seeing somebody crippled and saying they're going to be okay. But then you look at them and say, well, it doesn't look like that with the care. So we need to care for the cripple, right? Care for the... So they're visiting me, right? Sorry about me dropping that, but back again, caring for bees, it's very important. And bees are always looking for food, no matter what time of the year it is. And it depends where you're at. If you're out in the snow country, well, they're probably not gonna come out, right? Out here in Northern California, in California in general, we're a little different here. Our bees kind of live year round, and their brood kind of still exists during the winter time. We still have bees being developed. Back to feeding though. On the feeding part of this, I feed because sometimes they can't find enough food. The drought, the heat, and how far the place can be. And sometimes places are too far to go. And I don't want my bees going too far because sometimes they don't come back. And you don't want your bees to go out too far. That's my opinion. But today, we're feeding. Take a look. So we're feeding bees. And they are actually, take a look. They might sting me. I don't want them to sting me. There it is. Take a look at that. Now, they're having sugar water with pure sugar. Now, they're eating this because it's not that much plant food for them. And now they're gonna grab these resources and put away for the winter. Well, I have a medium hive here that had some honey on it. I threw some sugar on here and they're going right through it. It took them a while to get here, But look at my bees, they're very healthy. And I might be bees from other places, but most likely these bees are from here in this yard. Look how healthy they look. This is what I do. I keep healthy bees so they can have a healthy winter and they can make it through the winter. Some of these bees are winter bees, some are not. You can't tell by looking at them, you have to go into the hives. But this is what it looks like when you feed them. Enjoy a moment of bee feeding. We're having cooler nights, but look at these bees, how big they are. Look how fat they are. They're healthy bees. And we're ready to go in the winter. So you need to have your bees ready for winter. And that's what I'm doing right now, making sure that they have enough food to get through the winter. Now, if you pull your honey supers and you don't have no honey left, you're probably gonna have to do this, but more aggressive. It's gonna cost you more. So I leave honey in my hives. If you notice on my hives, I have bottoms. I have tops. And if you look at my hive, I got mediums, two deeps, and a lot of bees. Look how healthy these guys look. Look at this hive. Now this is a 2-year-old hive, almost 2 years old, and I've been keeping this hive for almost 2 years. We might have a new queen in there, we might not, but this next year we'll be replacing this queen, no matter what. These hives I started out with, and it's 2 years old now. Look at my bees, look how healthy they look. And these are turning into winter bees. So these are winter bees. Look how fat they look, look how healthy they are. They've been treated and taken care for. Look how big they are. They're big and fat. That's what you want. You want bees that are ready for the winter. I got more, as you know, right down here. A whole apiary getting ready for winter. I'm getting them ready for winter. These are small hives one time, and they're growing. And these will be just like my honey production hives over there. That's what this will be. So we'll have more honey production next year. But these bees have to make it through the winter. But they're thriving. Look at them. This was a smaller hive, look at it now. Now they're checking for intruders because I just gave them some honey from that hive. See, you gotta give your bees real food. You want them to be organic. You don't want them to be GMO. So the feeding is done at a certain period of time. And then after that, you don't need to feed anymore. They'll use that for their energy to get out. And then they'll bring back the real stuff, the real nectar. Stuff that has lots of nutrients in it. But for now, we gotta make sure it's sound right, boys.